That depends on which part of the university you're working at. I'm in a department with 2 women and 40 men among the scientists. So that's extremely imbalanced. It's imbalanced compared to our student population. There's an enormous lack of role models. But of course, we also need the diversity in our department, which is completely missing.
I think when we achieve gender balance, we will improve research. And who's not interested in having excellent research? Until we do that, until we achieve gender balance, we can't be sure that we have the best research.
Well, I think it's important for at least 2 reasons. First of all, we tend to talk a lot about meritocracy and think about meritocracy when we think about how kind of people advance in the academic system. And as we see now, women are less likely to reach the top, and it questions perhaps whether we're actually getting the best people to the top of the system. So I think that's one important point. Another point is that without having women represented in research and innovation at universities, we may lack perspectives on certain stuff that may influence what kind of questions are asked, what kind of questions are addressed. So there's also an important issue here related to what kind of knowledge is produced and how that contributes to the societies we live in. So I think both of these issues are critical.
Well, there are a number of reasons, but the most obvious ones are economic. It is inoptimal not to use the talent you have in a population to its best use. And if, as we see from the statistics, there are only 20% of women in professorship positions that are the most important academic positions, then there are 30% that are not used to their full potential because a man has got the position instead of a more bright woman. So that's a very distinct economic-driven motive. But in my view, there are also more political or ideological motives for equality, and that is simply human rights. A woman should have the same possibilities as a man, and we must admit that they don't in the culture that we have. So in my view, there are 2 basic components driving equality for women, and that is economic motives, but also human rights motives.